In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can use the sound sensor to show audio on the serial plotter. For this tutorial, you'll need an Arduino, a sound sensor, and three jumper wires male to female. Before we deep dive into building the circuit, I'd like to explain how this sound sensor works. So in front of the sound sensor is a microphone, and there is also a potentiometer, which I'll explain later. Sound can be seen as sound waves, and our sensor captures these sound waves with its microphone. These sound waves are translated into a resistance, and this resistance is exactly the same as the amount of sound. So this means that where there's a lot of noise, then there is also a high resistance, and where it is almost silent, there's almost no resistance. This means that when we apply 5 volts to our board, that the sensor sends 5 volts to the out when there is a low resistance, so when there is almost no sound, and it sends around 0 when there's a lot of sound. But our board has a certain boundary to determine whether the signal will be seen as low or high. So here you can see that everything above the boundary will be seen as low, and everything below the boundary will be seen as high. The potentiometer I mentioned earlier can be turned clockwise and counterclockwise. This will adjust the level of this boundary, so you can move it up or you can move it down. When you run the sketch and you see only zeros or only ones, this probably means you have to adjust the potentiometer to a certain level where you can see the ones and the zeros depending on the sound. We're now going to build the circuit. The first step is to connect our sensor to the jumper wires. The green wire is connected to the out, the blue one to the ground, and the red one to the VCC. We're continuing by connecting the jumper wires to our Arduino. The red wire is connected to the 5 volt, the blue one to the ground, and the green one to the digital pin 8. We're now ready to have a look at the code. The code is pretty straightforward. On line 17, we've defined the out pin constant, and we set it to number 8, which is the pin number on the Arduino. The setup is also pretty straightforward. We just initialize the serial monitor, and then in the loop we print the value we've read on the out pin, and we do this with digital read on the out pin and print it to the serial monitor. So if I send this to my Arduino and I open here in tools the serial monitor, we see all the numbers plotting from line 24, and when I'm silent you see only once, and when I talk you see all these zeros going on. It's not continuously zeros because the Arduino is very fast, and between words I have a small piece of silence, so that's what you see here. But these zeros and ones are not so interesting, so what I'm going to do instead of opening the serial monitor, I open the serial plotter. And now you can see all the zeros and ones here in just a chart, but it's not very interesting. You can see when I say something, you can see when there is a silence, but it's not very interesting. We want to know more about the intensity of the sound. So what I'm going to do is change the code a bit so you can actually see a graph where you can see the intensity of the sound. And that's what I'm going to show you now. So I've changed the code a little bit. And what I did here was adding on line 18 the sample time. And what we're going to do is to sample the audio. And the number here in sample time is the number of milliseconds of a sample. So what this means is that every 10 milliseconds we take a sample and we count within those 10 milliseconds how much once we've seen from the sound sensor. Because we're using timing, we're going to use millis. So we have three variables, one to save the current time, one to save the last timestamp, and the elapsed milliseconds since the last time. We also need to store somewhere the value of the amount of ones within the sample time. So we have here a sample buffer value, and that one is 0, of course. The setup is the same, and we've changed the loop a little bit with some calculations. So we start by grabbing the current millis here, the millis timestamp at the moment, and store it in millis current. And then we can calculate the elapsed time since the last time sample was started. Then we read the out pin, and if this one is low, that means there is sound, we increase the sample buffer value. But this happens continuously, but we're not printing it immediately to the serial monitor. Therefore is this if on line 38. We check if the elapsed time is larger than the sample time, and if so, then we print the sample buffer value to our serial monitor. If so, we reset the sample buffer value to 0, and we set millis last to the last timestamp, and that's the same as millis current, which we've taken here from the millis. So I'm going to upload this to my Arduino, and then I'm opening the serial monitor, and you will see a lot of different numbers. So previously we had the zeros and the ones, but now there is also a counter going on, which shows us how much time I've talked in the sample time of 10 milliseconds. But it's also not so interesting since it's a bunch of numbers. So we're going to open the serial plotter. And while I'm talking, you see that there is a difference in the amplitude of the chart. So if I talk very silent or harder, then you can see the difference in the amplitude. So that's quite nice. We have now found a way with sampling to show audio in the Arduino plotter. So that's it for this tutorial. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comment. And in the description of this video, you'll find a link to the course material. The course material contains the code, the circuit diagram, and also a list with all the components used. I see you in the next video.